this?
I'm ready.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Who gives this bride to Austin? God bless you. It's a good answer. Well, Alicia's our niece, and Karen and I perform lots of weddings over the years as pastors. But usually I'm the one up front and Karen's in the back, and usually she's the one that's waving her arms and saying, I've missed a thing, I've forgotten something. And I'm like a typical husband. I'm like, what is she trying to say? I know you women that have husbands understand what I'm talking about. But Alicia made it easy today by asking Karen and I to both do the weddings, so she's up here to fill in the gaps. I'm sure there'll be a few things I may forget. But really, we wanted to just join together as marriage partners to honor God, but also to honor Alicia and Austin today. We thank you guys for allowing us to be a part of this.
And this is my first wedding from up front. So the first thing I did was blew out the candles. I don't know how many of you saw that. Because someone said someone lit the candles and they aren't supposed to be lit. So I came up and blew them out and realized that you guys had lit them. So, oh well. I just want to say what an honor this is. Thank you for asking us to do this. As Mark said, we teach premarital classes through our church, and we've done many of them. And a year ago last summer, we took Austin and Alicia through our premarital class by Zoom. And they had hoped and planned to get married a year ago, but through the advice and counsel of family and friends, they decided to wait a year, and I really want to commend them for that. That's hard to wait a year. But I think, you know, it just gave them more time to be prepared. And so I just thank you guys for doing that. Also, I don't know if everybody is aware that today is a special day. Today is the birthday of Alicia's mother. And so what a special day to honor Alicia's mom, my sister, Carrie. And I love what it says in Hebrews 12:1. It talked in Hebrews 11 about all the great people of faith who had lived before us and who had gone on to be with the Lord. And it says in the next chapter that since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, those people who have gone on before us, who see, who are cheering us on, and I think about your mom, about your grandma, about your grandparents, and the people that you love, and they're here just honored. And I know your mom just prayed for this day, and is so blessed that this day is here.
Well, we're going to get the intentions out of the way, because we want to make sure you guys know your intentions here. Austin, is it your intention today to take Alicia to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance and the holiness of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her as your best friend and wife in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping yourself only for her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Make sure you heard that.
And Alicia, is it your intention today to take Austin to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiness of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, respect and keep him as your best friend and husband in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, will you keep yourself only for him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
God bless you.
God bless you too. Well, marriage is a relationship designed and instituted by God. In the beginning, God created all things and declared they were good, except for one matter. God said it was not good for man to be alone, so God made Eve from Adam, and when Adam saw her, he said, "Whoa, man." Well, think about it. It's the first time he saw a naked woman. That was the name, that what a great gift God created to dispel loneliness. Both man and woman became complete in each other because this is the way God designed it and instituted it. It was God's idea from the beginning and still his plan today. He gives us instructions on how we're to carry out his plan. For example, he said, "For this cause, a man shall leave his father and mother, cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one. I love that cleaving part. So, Austin and Alicia, this means today you're being released from your initial family, and you're beginning a permanent new family for God's praise and glory. Austin and Alicia, you're going to be making a covenant with God, and they need, both these two need your guys' support in this covenant that they're making.
I would like to ask everybody in the audience, if you are able, would you please stand? As we all know, we need the support and help of family and friends in our life, and so we're asking you to make a covenant vow and a commitment also this day. And so I was asking that, would you, as friends and family, will you support God's word that says, for this cause, a man shall leave his father and mother, or a woman, and they will cleave to their wife or husband, and the two shall become one flesh. And what God has joined together, let no one separate. This includes you two. This includes parents, family, and friends until death separates you. And will you, as parents and as family and friends, support and honor God's word in this marriage covenant today? Please, everyone, if you agree to support this, will you say, I will?
I will.
Thank you very much. You may be seated.
Austin and Alicia, marriage is not a contract or a license that we're signing and entering into today. Rather, it is a covenant you're making today with the Lord Almighty, God Almighty, who's here with us. It says this in Deuteronomy 29, carefully follow the terms of this covenant so that you may prosper in everything you do. You're standing today in the presence of the Lord your God. You are standing here in order to enter in a covenant with one another, your Lord, your God, a covenant the Lord is making with you this day and sealing with an oath. And specifically for you, young Austin, says this in Malachi 2. The Lord is acting as your witness between you and the wife of your youth. She is your partner, the wife of our marriage covenant. Will not the Lord make you one? In flesh and spirit, you are his. So guard yourself in your spirit and do not break faith with the wife of your youth. All right, so who has the rings? See, I knew there was a reason why she was up here. I forgot about that. Okay, Austin, take this ring and place it. Oh, wrong ring. Well, there you go. Okay, so Austin, place the ring on Alicia's left hand. There you go. And repeat after me. I, Austin.
I, Austin.
Thank you, Alicia.
Thank you, Alicia.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. I pledge you my faithfulness. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God bless you.
All right, Alicia, let's see if we can get this ring.
The right one.
Put it on his
finger. Yeah, that's a lot.
For better,
for worse,
for richer,
for poorer,
Well, there's two candles behind us here that signifies two lights becoming one. You have been united by God. You are no longer two, but one. You surrender your individual liberties for shared privileges and responsibilities. Your two lives are by divine act being merged together for one, for God's glory. Christian marriage is a gift of two people coming together exclusively and permanently for a union for God's glory. You're to be one, one in mind, one in heart, one in affections. Work out your oneness in daily experience. Whatever sacrifices you may be required to make to preserve the common life, always make them generously. Sacrifice is normally difficult. Only love can make it easy. The quality of love you have for one another will be proved out by sacrifice. We have this example by this kind of love that God gave his only son. It is by God the Son that he loved us and laid down his life for our salvation. Greater love has no man than this, that he laid down his life for a friend. As friends of this new husband and wife team, please go light the unity candle now.
What a special gift God has given to the two of you. The gift of marriage is a lifelong partnership and friendship. God says in Ecclesiastes 4, 9-12, this is such a special scripture, two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other one up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may feel overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. You are joining yourself as husband and wife, as friends and partners, and with God there, that's a three-strand cord. So be thankful for this partner of your youth. Love, honor, cherish, support, and cheer each other on all the days of your life, and enjoy the partner and friend that God has given to you.
Let's pray together. God, what has taken place here today is good. Lord, would you help Austin as he becomes this new, exciting husband and head of this home? He represents you to love Alicia as Jesus loves the church. Give Austin wisdom constantly with your strength and your Holy Spirit. And Father, bless Alicia as she begins this new role as Austin's wife. She too needs your Spirit's fullness every day of your life. As you fill her with the fruits of the Spirit, may she be ready to show love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, all the fruits of the Spirit. And may her faith in you grow stronger and deeper every day. May they never take each other's love for granted, Lord, but may they experience the lasting commitment of togetherness expressed so many generations ago by Ruth in the book of Ruth, where she said this, "Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if anything but death separates you and me." Lord, bless this couple. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Well, we've all witnessed today Austin and Alicia's vows to each other in the holiness of marriage, and we have witnessed these commitments made before God. So So Austin and Alicia have given a pledge of their love for each other, and nothing but death can separate them now. We're witnesses of this marriage covenant, and we must also uphold these vows by encouraging and uplifting this couple as they journey through life. Now, by the virtue of the authority vested in me by Almighty God and by the state of California, I pronounce that you are now husband and wife in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Austin, I've been waiting a long time for this. It's been hard to do over the internet, Facebook. So get to it in person now. You may kiss the bride. All right. Well, let me introduce to you for the first time, Austin and Alicia Martin. To the left of me, to the building to the left. Go through the center doors, if you would, for the reception.